All right. Republicans feel that this removal of the individual mandate might provide a little bit more money and wiggle room here. Maine Senator Susan Collins says put that in there, and she's all but a no vote. Louisiana Republican Senator Bill Cassidy with us right now. Senator, very good to have you. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.
What do you make of this provision? The goal was to free up some monies, I guess, remove what is an onerous demand to make sure every American has health insurance coverage. But Susan Collins is saying it's kind of complicating things. What do you think?
I won't be surprised if she changes her mind. The individual mandate doesn't work. Yesterday's New York Times, basically from CBO's sources, is saying that it only works about 7% of the time. They used to say millions would be uninsured if we repealed it. Now they're not saying that. That's number one. Number two, it's a tax on low-income people. It is the poorest people who are paying this, 78% of them with an adjusted gross income of less than $50,000. So not only does it not work, it taxes poor people. We should get rid of it.
All right. That might prove a tough argument.
I'm not hearing anything.
Oops. Can you hear us, Senator? No more? All right. We have some audio issues with the senator here. Again, on this provision that's caused such consternation, you can wiggle about $330 billion over 10 years. That's revenue if you take away that provision that they could provide to maybe provide lower taxes for various different brackets, as well as provide other benefits or maybe speed up the corporate tax cuts. Remember, in the Senate plan, they're delayed a year. In the House plan, they're immediate. This is something that provides the cash to do that. Now, the flip side is a lot of Republican senators fear, like Senator Susan Collins, that it comes at a bad time and sort of revisits the third rail issue of controversies that Republicans would just as soon avoid. And it could raise taxes as a result. I'll try again if we have Senator Cassidy. I think you're back, Senator. I apologize for those problems there. But do you think that if this provision goes, the Senate has some other provisions to avoid the tax cut for corporations being delayed a year or finding ways to lower other tax rates? What are your thoughts
on that? Well, first let me speak about the individual mandate.
Sure.
The argument will be that it will increase premiums. CBO said, and I have an email from them, that it will raise premiums by 10% if you repeal the individual mandate. But if we do the Alexander Murray bill on cost share reduction payments, that will actually lower premiums by 25%. So we can net lower premiums if we concomitantly put forward the Alexander Murray bill on cost share reduction payments and lower the deficit. So I do think there is a way forward, even if Senator Collins is concerned about the individual mandate.
What did you think of, Senator, of the back and forth yet again between the President of the United States and your colleague Jeff Flake with the President after hearing of comments that the senator made on an open mic, said that, oh, he's going to be a no vote on tax cuts anyway. What did you think of that?
I'm not sure that Senator Flake will be a no vote on taxes. Republicans are all about lowering tax burden. We're all about lowering tax burden on those Americans who are middle class. There's actually common ground between he and the president there. And we're all about economic growth. So I think that's where Senator Flake is. Clearly, he and the president don't like each other. Maybe not personally, but at least in terms of policy. On this, I think there's common ground. I'd like to think that Senator Flake can get there.
The fact that they do have these run-ins a lot, do a lot of your colleagues feel it's a pretty unique and special club you're all in, 100 men and women here, that an attack on one is interpreted maybe negatively by others?
No. What is important is not ourselves, it is the American people. We have to come together so that this country moves forward. That's what I'm all about. And it's not Republican, it's not Democrat, it's not personal, it's about the American people. This tax bill lowers the burden on middle-class Americans, and it is a pro-growth agenda to increase wages to give better benefits. We can all be about that, and that is our goal.
Do you think it's still doable by Christmas?
Absolutely.
Do you think it's doable before that December 12th special election in Alabama that could flip Democrat the way things are looking now?
I do think it can be because, again, we decrease the tax burden upon middle-class Americans. We get rid of the individual mandate, which doesn't work, but taxes lower-income Americans. And it's a pro-growth policy. You put those three together, I think we get the votes we need.
Senator, thanks for taking the time. I apologize for the audio issues there in the beginning. I'm going to blame someone else, but certainly not myself. All right, Senator, very good seeing you. Have a great Thanksgiving.
You too, Neil. All right.